Hey everyone, I'm Kanay Gupta and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm gonna show you how to solve Sherlock and Harry hacker rank problem. But before moving ahead, make sure you have subscribed to my YouTube channel. Let's start. Guys, I'm assuming that you have gone through the problem description. If not, please pause this video for a minute and go through it once. But here I'll summarize this problem. In a short, here our task is to find an element of the array such that the sum of all elements to the left is equal to the sum of all elements to the right. Let's see this problem with the help of an example. We have given an array of 4 integers where we have 4 integers 5, 6, 8 and 11. So here 8 is the element such that the sum of all elements to the left is equal to sum of all elements to the right. So you can see sum of all elements to the left of the 8, 6 plus 5 which is equal to 11, is equal to sum of all elements to the right side of the 8 which is 11. So like that, if this such element exists in the array, you have to return yes. So we have to complete the balance sum function in the editor and it should return a string either yes if there is an element meeting the criteria or no otherwise. So this is the input format, guys. Here first line contains T, the number of test cases, and the next T pairs of line each represent a test case. The first line contains N, the number of elements present in the array. And the second line contains n space separated integers where I is ranged from 0 to n. So see this example, guys. Here 2 stands for number of test cases which we are going to execute, and 3 represent the element which should be present in the array. So you can see 3 element over here, and again we have one more test case. So 4 is the number of element which is present in the array, and these are the 4 elements. And our task is to identify in this array whether such element exists or not. So you can see in this array there is no such element whose left sum and right sum are both are equal. So in that case we are returning no here. In the same way, for this example, if you see, we can easily understand here 3 is the element such that the left sum of the element towards left side of the array and right sum towards this element both are equal. So 1 plus 2, 3 here, and here if you see the right sum, also 3. So it means there is such element which exists in this array whose sum of all the elements toward the left and all the elements toward the right side both are equal. So that is why we are returning yes here. Let's see the algorithm behind it, guys. So let's assume, guys, we have an array which is a random array. So in that element exists such that the sum of left side of all the elements is equal to sum of right side all the elements. So I'm assuming that element is represented via y, and it exists in between somewhere. So the sum of left side of the element is represented via x. As I said, the sum of all the elements toward the left side is equal to sum of all the elements toward the right side of that element. So the right side sum also can be represented via x. So by seeing this, we can easily say sum of all the elements present inside the array should be equal to x plus y plus x. Right? So here x plus y plus x will be equal to sum of all the elements. Here, guys, some of all the elements. I'll use sum here to represent sum of all the elements. So I'm just simplifying this equation and writing it down again. So it's a 2x plus y equals to sum, where sum represents sum of all the elements. So if you simplify it again, you'll get 2x equals to sum minus y. And this can be marked as a equation number 1, where x is the left sum. So guys, this is the equation which we got. So if we have x and y such that this equation holds true, it means there is one element exist. Correct? Because in this equation we have two unknowns, x and y. So we have to first get the value of x and y, and then we'll place both the values inside this equation and see whether LHS equals to RHS or not. LHS equals to RHS means there's some element exist inside the array where sum of all the elements toward the left side of that element is equals to right side of that element. So let's take one example array. This is the example array, guys. And first I'll calculate sum of all the elements. So I'll just calculate sum of all the elements, which is equals to 40. Now I'll place this 40 inside the equation 1. So the equation will look something like this, and marking as a equation 2. Now our task is to see whether LHS equals to RHS or not. So what is y here? Guys, as we are not aware about the y, but y, that is for sure, y will be belongs to any one of the element which is present inside the array. So we'll take one element at a time from the array and replace y with that element. Like that, x also, we will take the x value based on y, whatever it comes, and replace in this equation and see whether LHS equals to RHS or not. If we found any such pair of x and y where LHS equals to RHS, means we have that element inside the array which holds this criteria true, and we will return yes. So I am looping through the array and taking one element at a time and replacing in place of y. So let's see, guys. I am assuming first element is a y here. Then what will be the x? X is the sum of all the elements toward the left side of the y, or either right side of the y. But here, suppose I am using for loop, so I will go from 0 to n minus 1 inside the array. So see the left side of the y, what is present? Nothing. It means here x equals to 0. So I will take x equals to 0 and y equals to 3 and put those value inside the equation number 2. So what I will get? So I will get 0 and RHS, I will get 37. So here we can see LHS is not equal to RHS. It means 3 cannot be a y. So let's move ahead, and now I'll take the second element as a y. So guys, here what we need to see, whenever I am moving and changing the y position, our x will take that y and add it to the initial value. Well, let's see in next diagram. Yeah, so here you can see 7 will be a y this time, because first we have already tested, so this is not a right element, it doesn't hold this condition true. So now we move to the second element, and assuming this is the one element which we are looking for, and the sum of all the elements toward this left side will be equal to sum of all the elements toward the right side. So y is 7, and what will be the x? So the x will be the initial value, whatever it was there, 0, plus whatever the y it was there before. Whatever the y value was there before, we will add that into the x. So now the x will be 3 and y will be 7, and we'll place that value inside the equation 2. So what we got? We got 6 on our left hand side and 33 on the right hand side, which is not equal. So it means this is also not the correct element which we are looking for. So again, we'll move y one step ahead, and now this time 7 will be a part of x. So if you see in this diagram, y will be equals to 5 and the old y 7 will be a part of x. So the x value will be 3 plus 7, which is equals to 10, and y will be 5. So we'll replace x with 10 and y with 5 inside equation 2, and we get 20 on left hand side and 35 on our right hand side, which is not equal. So again, we'll move ahead and check for next element. So now this time y is 10 and x will be 3 plus 7 plus 5, which is equals to 15. So now I'll put x equals to 15 and y equals to 10 inside the equation second, and I'll get 30 on left hand side and 30 on right hand side. So you can see, guys, both are equal, left hand side equals to right hand side here. So it means this is the element which we were looking. So it means there exists some element inside the array where sum of all the elements towards the left side is equals to sum of all the elements towards the right side. So I hope, guys, you got this idea what we are trying to do in this question. So let's summarize this in some simple steps which will make it as an algorithm. First, we are going to calculate the sum of all elements of the array, and we'll store it as a sum. Next, we are going to loop through all the element and taking each element one by one and assuming this is the y which we are looking for. And we'll check whether if 2 times of x equals to sum minus y, is this condition is true or not. If this condition is true, it means there is some element exists inside the array where sum of all the elements towards the left side is equals to sum of all the elements towards the right side. So we have to return yes. If it's not true, then we will add that y into the x value and move to the next element. So we'll keep on doing these things until we find such element. If there is no such element exist, by default we'll return no. I hope, guys, this is clear to you. Now let's see this algorithm in action, guys. So this is the function, guys. Here we have a list. So guys, I have shown you that example using an array, but in HackerRank template there's a list. So there's not much difference there because internally list also uses array. So we'll see. So this is the x, guys. Initially it will be 0 because left side of y nothing is there, so we are assuming initially x is 0, and I have taken a sum variable which is also 0. So first we have to calculate the sum of all the elements. So this is the for each loop, guys. So I have adding all the array element and storing inside the sum. Now after that, I am taking all the element and using for each loop again, and each and every time I am treating every element as a y and checking whether this condition is true or not, whether there is such element exists inside the array which holds this condition. If there is such element, we are returning yes. If we did not find that, then we are adding that y in the x, because every time whenever you shift y, x width will increase by y. So now the x value will change. So next time x value will be changed and y value will also be the next element. So you have to keep try with all the elements. If there's some value exist which holds this property true, then we have to return yes. Else by default we'll return no. I hope you got the idea, guys. Now I'll take this code and try to run on a HackerRank platform. Let me run the test case. So you can see, guys, sample test case got passed. Now I'm submitting this code. Congratulations, guys. You have done a great job. So all test cases got passed. Guys, if you have any kind of doubt in this question, please let me know in the comments. And you can download the source code from my GitHub repository, and the link is mentioned in the description box. I have one request, guys. I have used X and Y here just to show you, because it relates to the algorithm which we have discussed. But please don't use such kind of variable whenever you write code. Use appropriate variable with the proper naming convention, because this is not a good practice. But just I want to make sure you'll get the same feel which we have got while discussing the algorithm. That's why I've used X and Y. Okay, guys, thanks for watching, and please don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe.